Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Praise
Hallelujah.
So welcome everyone today. Welcome you all into the service. I know we've gone through challenges, went through happiness, success and failure, and by God's grace we made it today.
Amen.
In presence. So let's start to invite the Holy Spirit in our presence. For the Holy Spirit to invite you to be in our presence in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Invite you.
Holy Spirit,
let's invite the Holy Spirit into this service. Holy Spirit, invite you to our service today in the name of Jesus. We invite you in our presence today in the name of Jesus. Holy Spirit, invite you to our service today in the name of Jesus. For in Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Holy Spirit, have your way in this service in the name of Jesus. Have your way to this service in the name of Jesus. Holy Spirit, have your way into this service in the name of Jesus. Holy Spirit, have your way into this service in the name of Jesus. Have your way to this service in the name of Jesus. Holy Spirit, have your way to this service. In Jesus' name we pray. Spirit of God, fill our heart, soul, and mind in the name of Jesus. Spirit of God, fill our heart, soul, and mind in the name of Jesus. Spirit of God, fill our heart, soul, and mind in the name of Jesus. Spirit of, yes, fill our mind, fill our heart, fill our soul in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Oh God, encourage us as we are in your presence in the name of Jesus. Oh God, encourage us as we are in your presence in the name of Jesus. Oh God, encourage us as we are in your presence in the name of Jesus. Oh God, encourage us as we are in your presence in the name of Jesus. Oh God, as we are in your presence, encourage us, teach us, encourage us, bless us as we are in your presence in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Oh God, reveal deeper secret things to us in the name of Jesus. Oh God, reveal deeper secret things to us in the name of Jesus. Reveal deeper secret things about us, about our families, about our children, about our spouse, about our friends in the name of Jesus. Oh God, our Father, reveal the persecutings. Reveal the persecutings. For in Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Please join me sing this song. Hallelujah.
My God, how excellent is your name in all.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. We are welcome to today's service. Let's be in the spirit to worship the Lord. Thank you.
Amen. Everybody shout hallelujah. Let's begin to thank the Lord for what he has done. What he's still doing. Say, Father, I thank you.
Thank you.
I glorify your name, King of Kings, Lord of Lords, Ancient of Days. I am that I am, omnipotent God, omniscience God. I worship you today. I glorify your name. Take all the glory. You deserve all the glory. You deserve all the honor. You deserve all the adoration, King of Kings. I worship you, Lamb of God. I worship you, Lord. Blessed be your name, O God. Adonai Elion, El Shaddai. I worship you. I glorify your name in the name of Jesus. Father, Lord, you are the lily of the valley. You are the rose of Sharon. You are the bright and morning star. You are the chief commander. You are the creator of the universe. You are the creator of everything. Above, beneath, and everywhere. I worship you today. I adore you. Yes. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father.
Jesus' name we pray. Holy Ghost fire, incubate us afresh.
Jesus' name we pray. The word of God says, if my people who are called by my name shall humble themselves and pray and seek thy face and turn away from their wicked ways, then you will hear from heaven. You will forgive your sins and you are left. Let's begin to ask God for forgiveness. Say, every sin that will be an hindrance to today's service, we confess them as one body in Christ in the name of Jesus. Every sin will be an hindrance. Yes, we confess them as one body in Christ in the name of Jesus. Father, Lord, have mercy upon us. Yes, you are a merciful Father. You are a forgiving Father. You said if you open our mouth and pray and ask you for forgiveness, you will forgive us. You will wash us clean with the blood of Jesus. Yes, Father, Lord, have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon us in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Every satanic gathering has stand against today's program. Oh, yeah, scatter my fire. You don't have to scatter them. Holy Ghost, arise with your fire. Holy Ghost, arise with your fire. Ready to deliver, ready to save. Ready to deliver, ready to set us free. Holy Ghost, arise.
Thank you. Father, we thank you. Be thou exalted.
In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Now let's approach the presence of God once again and say, Lord Jesus, have mercy upon me. In the name of Jesus, Lord Jesus, have mercy upon me. Your word says, I will have mercy on Jacob, and we yet choose Israel. Have mercy upon us this morning, O God, for you are a good, good Father. Have mercy upon us, O God. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Say, Oh Lord, send your restoration power into my life this morning. In the name of Jesus. Lord Jesus, send your restoration power into my life this morning. In the name of Jesus. Your restoration power. Your resurrection 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 power. Into my life, into my family, into my root, into my foundation, into my life, into my family, into my life, into my family. Your resurrection power. Your resurrection power. Your resurrection power. Your resurrection power. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Say everything in my life. Entering the presence of God. Come on! In the name of Jesus. Everything in my life. Entering the presence of God. Out! 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 In the name of Jesus. Come out! Come out! Come out! Come out! Come out! 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 In the name of Jesus. Out! Everything in my life. That is entering the presence of God. That is entering the presence of Jesus. That is entering the presence of God. I send you out. I send you back in the name of Jesus. Any spirit, any demon in my life that is in the presence of God. Any mortal of flesh in my life, in the presence of God. I send you out in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Say, I challenge my inner man with the fire of the Holy Spirit. In the name of Jesus, I challenge my inner man. With the fire of the Holy Spirit, you are in the man. Receive the fire of God. Receive the fire of the Holy Spirit. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus, mighty name we pray.
In the name of Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
Heal every form of backsliding.
Heal every form of backsliding.
In my life. In the name of Jesus. Lord Jesus. Heal every form of backsliding in my life. In the name of Jesus. Every form of backsliding. Every form of lukewarmness. Heal it, O God. Heal it, O God. Heal it, O God. In the name of Jesus. Heal every form of backsliding. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Say, Lord Jesus, uproot every seed of darkness from my foundation. In the name of Jesus. Lord Jesus, uproot every seed of darkness. Every form of darkness. Every seed of darkness in my foundation. Uproot it. Uproot it. Uproot it. Uproot it. Uproot it. Uproot it. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Anything that the Lord has not planted in my life, be uprooted.
Be uprooted.
Be uprooted. By fire. Be uprooted. By fire. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Say, I fire back.
I fire back.
Beloved, catch fire. I fire back.
I fire back.
I fire back. Every hour of darkness, fire against my life, fire into my family. I fire you back. 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 Every hour of darkness,
fire
into my life. To my family. Go back. Go back. Go back. Go back. Go back. In the name of Jesus. Every
life. Reject bewitchments. In the name of Jesus. I refuse to be bewitched.
Do
my life, do my head. Reject bewitchments. Reject bewitchments.
Reject
bewitchments.
Reject bewitchments.
Whoever is calling your name for evil, let the fire of God send that. In the name of Jesus. Wherever your name is used for evil, let the fire of God appear. You are here. Reject bewitchments. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Father, we thank you for your presence this morning. Lord, we pray, O God, that you help us as we want to listen to your word, to understand your word, and help us to act on your words. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' mighty name we are praying.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Shall we have our seats? Once again, I welcome you all to the presence of God. Thank God for those of us who are able to make it this morning, even in this very interesting weather. Beloved, before we go on, I have a message for all of us. And the message is this: Jesus Christ is coming soon. Jesus Christ is coming soon.
What do you need?
Rapture. We have it. Just because people are not talking about it, doesn't mean it won't happen. The Bible says, I watch over my words to perform it. So, Jesus is coming soon. So, in any moment, any day, the way you live your life, please check yourself. If trumpet sounds now, where do I stand? Will I meet God? Or will I be left behind? I pray that I will not be left behind in the name of Jesus. Amen. Our text this morning, we quickly go to the book of Psalms, chapter 91. Psalm chapter 91. I believe by now we all know this passage. COVID made this part of the passage popular. Praise the Lord. But it shouldn't be used for COVID. This is not a passage you use when you are, just because you have the pestilence. But we are not trying to look at this passage. We just want to, the Spirit of the Lord wants to teach us something from this passage. Psalm chapter 91. If you are there, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Read from verse 1 to 4. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, is my refuge and my fortress, my God. In him will I trust. Surely he shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. He shall cover thee with his feathers, and under his wings shalt thou trust. His truth shall be thy shield and buckler. So the title of our message is, His truth is my shield and my buckler. His truth is my shield and my buckler. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
As you all know, this psalm was written by Moses. If there's any person who could understand dwelling in the secret place of the Most High, after our Lord Jesus Christ, I think we're talking about Moses. You know, the Bible says no man has seen God. But at least Moses saw the form of God. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
So he understood what it means to dwell in the presence of God. When the Bible is talking about the truth, what was the writer saying here? When he's talking about the truth, is it just because the truth? Yes, the truth, the truth, the truth, my shield. Because a lot of us, when this pandemic started, by the grace of God, As a Christian, these are some of the passages that we are supposed to memorize. And you recite it. So, saying, he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High during the COVID time, alone, that's not a good use of it. It's like somebody who did not save up for the rainy day. You don't build your credit, and all of a sudden, you realize you need a car. And now, you go to the dealership, you say, yeah, the credit should be available to me too. But you didn't build your credit. So what would the dealer say? I can give you either you pay cash, or you show me your credit history. Mm-hmm. And so, you see many people, they live in sin, dwell in sin, no righteousness. Yes, when COVID came, they were reading Psalm 91 to 1. Praise the Lord. It doesn't work that way. Dwelling is anywhere you go, they find you there. Consistently. Daily. Every hour. Every minute. The Lord trained Moses for 40 years. He was training him into ministry. And Psalm 91 is just not a psalm that is for everybody. If you go deeper, Psalm 91 are for people who are deep, who have learned to walk with the Lord. But we thank God for His mercy because even when we do it, it works. Because the Lord is merciful. But we want to focus on three words. His truth is my shield and my buckler. Now I want to define the truth, the shield, and the buckler. And we will now combine three together quickly. We don't have much time. The Hebrew word used for truth is emeth, which you can interpret as firmness, sureness, reliability, and faithfulness, trustworthiness. I will say it again. Truth, the Hebrew word used for truth is emeth. E-M-E-T-H. E-M-E-T-H. And it means firmness, sureness, reliability, faithfulness, trustworthiness. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So when the Bible is talking about His truth is my shield and my buckler, the Bible is talking about His faithfulness is my shield and is my buckler. So we pick the word faithfulness from this because that's the word that really, really makes sense. So again, the Hebrew word used for truth is emeth, interpreted as firmness, sureness, reliability, trustworthiness. In the book of Psalm 91 that we read, verse 4, that's why if you read the NIV version, the Bible says, His faithfulness will be your shield and rampart. That is where they got their interpretation from. Now, what is a shield? When you think about a shield, you think about those old-time soldiers. They wear their armor. Praise the Lord. So, a shield, you use it to guard your arm, everything. So, and then when you think about the shield now, you can think about bulletproof. But all those things are nothing when you are comparing the kind of shield we get from God because of His faithfulness. A shield is a framework of wood covered with leather, cased with metal and either brass or copper, usually bronze. And you can see that in the book of Ezekiel chapter 39 verse 9. Praise the Lord. Ezekiel chapter 39 verse 9, but we won't read that. The Hebrew word for shield is sinar. which I spell T-S-I-N-N-A-H. It means a large shield, a hook, a barb, used in setting up a barrier and a shield. So, by the grace of God, those of us who came from Nigeria, so after spending millions of naira to build your house, then you have to spend another money to build your fence. And on top of that fence, what do they put? Barbed wire. So, what the barbed wire is saying is, you are not allowed to come in. But even though you try to come in, you'll be hurt. Praise the Lord. But you can't even compare that. We still cannot compare that to the kind of shield that God has given us as believers. We don't have much time, but I will try to summarize this thing because it is not about saying this or that, but it is about the substance that you can get from this message that the Spirit of the Lord is teaching us. When God protects you, what God is saying to the enemies, first of all, don't go near this person. Now, if you try to go near him, you are doing so at your own peril. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
When God is protecting you, he's not only saying to the enemy, don't go near that brother. You go there, you'll be destroyed. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Quickly, the book of Genesis. Chapter 15, verse 1. Please, if you are there, we can read it. Genesis, chapter 15, verse 1. After these things, the word of the Lord came unto Abraham in a vision, saying, fear not, Abraham. I am what? I am thy shield. The reason why we are saying is truth is my shield and my buckler is that even though God has promised to be our shield, his faithfulness to that promise is still our shield. Because some people can promise you and they can let you down. Praise the Lord. Now he said, I am thy shield and thy exceeding great reward. Now let's look at the book of Genesis chapter 20. Genesis chapter 20. So, we know what happened to Abimelech. And Abraham said of his wife, I read from verse 2, she is my sister. And Abimelech, king of Gerar, sent and took Sarah. But God came to Abimelech in a dream by night and said to him, behold, thou art but a dead man. Now, this man did not even attack Abraham, though. He took Abraham by his words. Sarah is my sister. And fair enough, Abraham was not lying. It was just two truths. He didn't tell the other part. He told the first half. Sarah is my sister, but now she's my wife. But he only told one half. And even on top of that, God said, thou art but a dead man. Now, think about somebody who now tried to attack Abraham. Worse than dead. Praise the Lord. That is what it means when we are saying, his truth is my shield and my buckler. Praise the Lord.
Yeah.
Now we read the book of Genesis, also chapter 12, verse 14, to the king of Pharaoh, when God dealt with Pharaoh as well, because of the same Sarah. It looked like this thing as a like that time, people love women a lot, so and they kept snatching people's someone else's woman. But the Bible says in the book of Romans, chapter 12, verse 19. Romans, chapter 12, verse 19. Dearly beloved, avenge not yourselves, but rather give place unto what? Unto wrath. For it is written, vengeance is mine, I will repay. So what the Bible is telling us is, give place unto wrath. Let God be angry because of you. Let the enemy tear you. Because what? His truth, which is his faithfulness, is my shield, my buckler. Because God will never let me down. Praise the Lord. So, we've talked about protection. Shield is anything that protects, that defends. One that protects a piece of defensive armor. There are many texts that we can read according to the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 33, verse 29, 2 Samuel, chapter 22, verse 3. The book of Psalm, chapter 3, verse 3 says, for thou, O Lord, art a shield for me, my glory, the lifter up of my head. So, we've defined a shield. And buckler is another form of a shield. We will not have time to go into details. But in summary, you can define it as a bulwark, which is to surround. So, the promises of God, the faithfulness, is acting as a shield for us. And is surrounding us. That's why in the book of Job, the devil had to take permission from God to attack Job. Let's quickly look at the book of Job, chapter 1. As long as you are righteous and you are living a holy life, see, there are some benefits. It's good to pray for protection, but that is your God-given right. That is your promise. It is what you earn without even asking for it. Because you are righteous. And the Lord said unto Satan, when thou comest thou? When comest thou? Then Satan answered the Lord and said, from going to and fro in the earth, and from walking up and down in it. And the Lord said unto Satan, as thou canst consider my servant Job, that there is none like him in the earth, a perfect and an upright man, one that feareth God and escheweth evil. Then Satan answered the Lord and said, doth Job fear God for naught? Hast not thou made an edge about him? And about his house? And about all that he hath on every side? Thou hast blessed the work of his hands, and his substance is increased in the land. So, because of the righteousness of Job, this entire family had that edge of protection around him. Praise the Lord. His faithfulness is my shield and my refuge. Now, Satan said, put forth thy hand now and touch all thy heart, and it will cause thee to thy face. And the Lord said unto Satan, behold, all that he hath is in thy power. Only upon himself put not forth thy hand. So that's the permission. If God did not approve that, Satan will never dare to touch you. His faithfulness is my shield and my refuge. The reason why we are saying this is sometimes as humans, we get carried away with our anxieties and fear. But it is very, very important to reassure ourselves and know the God that we serve. Is the faithful God. Praise the Lord. So, when you are talking about a buckler, it means a gatekeeper. So, in the book of Colossians, chapter 3, verse 3, Colossians, chapter 3, verse 3. Please, if you are dead, read it. For ye are dead, and your life is what is it with Christ in God. The moment you are dead to sin, God takes over your entire life. And his faithfulness, his truth, will be your shield and will be your buckler. No power. Unless God gives them the permission. unless you are not faithful, unless an hedge is broken. And that is why, as Christians, it is very, very important to make sure that we observe all the laws and the commandments of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
So that when the devil comes, he will find nothing in us. Jesus said, the prince of this world cometh and found nothing, 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 nothing. The Bible says, for he that loveth, in the book of James, you keep yourself and the evil one toucheth him not. I forgot the verse now. Praise the Lord. So when you keep yourself, when you purify yourself, when you walk in righteousness, there is no way the devil will attack you. Psalm chapter 34, verse 7. The book of Psalm chapter 34, verse 7. The Bible says, the angel of the Lord encampeth around those that fear him, and deliver what? And deliver them. So, in terms of God's faithfulness, God is always faithful to those who belong to him. In the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 9, Hebrews chapter 10, verse 23 also. His faithfulness is incomparable. Psalm chapter 89, verse 8. Now you know the meaning of a shield and a buckler and the truth. The truth is telling us about the faithfulness of God. Now the faithfulness of God, he remains faithful even when we are unfaithful. When Abraham departed and left for Egypt and went to Egypt, God did not tell him to go to Egypt. And if you read the story very well, if you read history, Hagar came into the picture after Abraham left Egypt. So he acquired Hagar from Egypt. And you see the problem of Hagar. So when you go away from the presence of God, God will still remain faithful. Don't get me wrong, he will still remain faithful. But there are some attachments that you get to yourself that you only will have to deal with that. He will still remain faithful. You can always count on God's faithfulness. Isaiah chapter 40, verse 31. Isaiah chapter 43 from verse 1 to 2. You can always count on his faithfulness. You can always count on his faithfulness. His faithfulness is great. In the book of Lamentations chapter 3 from verse 22 to 23. The Bible says it is by the Lord's mercy that we are not consumed. Let's quickly read it. Lamentations chapter 3 from verse 22 to 23.
It is of the Lord's mercies
mm-hmm.
that we are not consumed.
Mm-hmm.
Because his compassions fail not.
Mm-hmm.
They are new every morning.
Mm-hmm.
Great is thy faithfulness.
Great is thy faithfulness. You can also have, the word great also means mighty, powerful, fierce, and fearsome. The Lord said in the book of Jeremiah chapter 1 verse 12, if you read the American Standard Version, he says, I watch over my words to perfect it. So when God has promised us to protect us, he will definitely protect us. All we need to do is just take our refuge in him. Praise the Lord. They ask you to wear PPE at work. You must wear PPE at work. But PPE will not protect you. Only God can protect.
Amen.
And the moment God realizes that this son trusts me, I will not let him die. Because he's faithful. words can be relied upon to keep us safe. The Bible says in the book of Proverbs chapter 18 verse 10, it says, the name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous runs into it, and he is safe. Shall we arise up? Amen. His truth is my shield, my buckler. Though I pass through fire, it shall not consume me. Let's read it in the book of Isaiah chapter 43.
Hey,
I just feel like going on and on. Bible says from verse 1, but now see the Lord that created thee, O Jacob, and he that formed thee, O Israel. Fear not, for I have redeemed thee. Praise the Lord. How many of us are redeemed? Raise up your hands if you are redeemed. I am redeemed. I am redeemed. Thank you, Jesus. I have called thee by my name. Thou art mine. When thou passest through the waters, I will be with thee. And through the rivers, they shall not overflow thee. When thou walkest through fire, thou shalt not be burned. This is a promise that the Lord has given us. Even in the midst of pandemic, I shall not be moved. His food is my shield and my buckler. And I shall not be moved. I will trust in God and God only. I will not trust in all these politicians. Yes. I will not trust in flesh. Or in the hand of flesh. The Bible says, neither that shall the flame kindle upon thee. His faithfulness is my shield. His faithfulness is my buckler.
Amen.
Begin to worship him.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
The Lord will not leave me alone. He will not forsake me. Because I am redeemed.
The shadow of death. I shall not
fear. I am saved.
For they are with me.
Though my friends forsake me, I shall not be moved. For I am like a tree planted by the rivers. His faithfulness is my shield. His faithfulness is my buckler. His faithfulness is my refuge. The Lord will never leave me nor forsake me. Begin to worship him. He has promised. He will never fail. I will follow him. I will follow him. He has promised. He will never fail. His faithfulness is forevermore. His faithfulness is forever. I will not visit the Amalis. I will not forsake God. For his faithfulness is my strength. His faithfulness is my shield. Place for me, and the Lord has prepared me for this place. faithfulness is my shield. His truth is my buckler. And I will not leave him nor forsake him. Though friends may discourage me. Beloved, you must be saying that to yourself now. You must profess your faith. You must rededicate your life to God. If there is a way that you've been unfaithful to Him, in your deeds, in your imaginations, you've been praying to God for many things and it looks like it's not working, and yet you are getting discouraged. And so because of you are getting discouraged, you don't want to come to church, you don't want to serve God. His faithfulness is my shield. His faithfulness is my buckler. The Lord will not let me down because He's a faithful God. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this morning. Lord, we pray, O God, that you help us to remain faithful. Because no matter what happens, you remain faithful. And you will never fail us. But we have failed you, and failed you, and failed you, and failed you, and failed you. We come back to you, O God, and we repent. We present our body unto you as a living sacrifice. We pray, O God, that you redeem us afresh. And let your spirits possess our lives afresh. And give us wisdom. Give us patience to wait upon you. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. I invite Rabiola for offering.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Praise the living Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Are you happy to be in His presence today?
Yes.
The hallelujah is somehow. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Are we happy?
Yes. We are happy.
I still don't like that. If I don't like it, I don't know much more of God. Yes. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
We are sounding as if we are healed and healthy now. Thank God.
Yes.
It's time to give our tithes and offering.
Amen.
Say, give and shall be given unto you. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, shall men give unto your bosom. Father, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Father, in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Heavenly Father, we thank you for this wonderful time in your presence. We thank you for restoring the fortunes of your people.
Amen.
We thank you for blessing the apostles. God, we give you adoration. We give you all praise. Be thou exalted in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Heavenly Father, we thank you for this wonderful time. We thank you for bringing us together. We thank you, cause as we be going up to the God, your protection is there for us. We thank you, cause I know we'll never fall. We never fall short of any good thing in the mighty name of Jesus. And as we give unto your wondrous moment, O God, we will continue to bless us and enlarge our host in the mighty name of Jesus. And everything we desire shall be granted unto us in due time in Jesus' name. We thank you, we glorify your holy name. For in Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Yeah.
a wonderful time in His presence. Quickly, our scripture of the week. Please, let's bring our bulletin. Remind us our scripture of the week for last week. Without looking at your bulletin, bro.
Psalm 24, verse 10.
Amen. Amen. Yes.
Clap for me.
You haven't read it.
No, I meant to read it.
Who is this King of Glory?
The
Lord of hosts is the King of Glory. Psalm chapter 55, verse 22.
Is that our test for today?
No. Our first week. The scripture of our first service. Psalm 55, verse 22. Cast thy burdens upon the Lord, and he shall sustain thee. He shall never suffer the righteous to be moved. Praise the Lord. Last 2 weeks, Deuteronomy chapter 6, verse 5. This week, the Bible says, Matthew chapter 5, verse 10, blessed are they which are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Praise the Lord. Matthew chapter 5, verse 10. Matthew chapter 5, verse 10. Let's read it together. Blessed are they which are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Matthew chapter 5, verse 10. Brethren, let's not forget our weekly activities. I pray that as you join us, the Lord will bless you in the name of Jesus. Shall we all rise up? We welcome our daddy into our midst this morning. Please, let's welcome him. Let's pray for him. Let's pray for him. That the Lord will bless him. That the Lord will lift him up. Let's stretch our hands and pray for him. Thank you, Jesus.
Bless him. Father, come upon him with your fire.
In Jesus' mighty name we pray. And we also want to welcome our sister into our midst.
Amen.
Honored to have in our midst. Praise the Lord. Our prayer for this month that we are doing for the church will start as soon as we end this service. I pray that if you want to join us, please, we'll do it real quick and we'll end by 1 p.m. Praise the Lord. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this afternoon. Thank you for what you've done in our lives and in our midst. Lord, we pray, oh God, as we go this week, your face will shine upon us in the name of Jesus. We pray, oh God, for your protection. We pray for provision. We pray for those who are yet to know you as their personal Lord and Savior, that you touch their heart in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Heavenly Father, that on Sunday, oh God, we'll have focus to glorify your name. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Let's share the grace and fellowship. The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit, be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Three powerful hallelujah. 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 Amen.